Good morning, students. Today we are going to see Standard 7th History, Chapter Number 10, The Expansion of the Maratha Power. Let's start with the topic. At the beginning of the Maratha War of Independence, the Mughals were on the offensive whereas the Marathas were on the defensive. The situation, however, was reversed at the end of the War of Independence. The Mughals were thrown on the defensive against the Marathas. In the latter half of the 18th century, the Marathas subdued the Mughals and extended the Maratha power to So as what we are going to study in this chapter, about how the Marathas subdued the Mughals and they had extended the power of Maratha in all the parts of our country, that we are going to see in this present chapter, The Expansion of the Maratha Power, chapter number 10. Let's start with the first point, Release of Shahu. After the death of Emperor Aurangzeb, there ensued a struggle amongst his sons for the throne of Delhi. Prince Azam Shah was in the south. At once, he marched towards the Delhi to siege the imperial throne. Prince Shahu was in his captivity. Azam Shah believed that if Shahu Maharaj was released, there would arise a conflict between him and Maharani Tarabai for the gaddi of the Maratha Chhatrapati. Azam Shah felt that this would sap the Maratha strength and therefore release Shahu Maharaj. So as in this content, they had given that after the death of Emperor Aurangzeb, they had ensured the struggle among his sons for the throne of Delhi, due to which the Prince Azam Shah from south, he marched towards the Delhi to siege the imperial throne, and also the Prince Shahu was in the captivity of the Prince Azam Shah. So he thought that if he will relieve the Shahu Maharaj, so what will happen in Maratha territory between Maharani Tarabai and between Shahu Maharaj, it will be fight between both of them for the gaddi. So as by feeling the insecurity of Maratha territory, Azam Shah felt to leave Shahu Maharaj from his captivity and to have a fight between Maharani Tarabai and Shahu Maharaj. So due to this decision, he thought to release Shahu Maharaj from his captivity. Coronation of Shahu Maharaj. Immediately after his release, Shahu Maharaj marched towards Maharashtra. So as when Azam Shah he released from the control of Mughals, he marched to Maharashtra. He was joined by some Maratha Sardars, but Maharani Tarabai did not accept his claim to the throne. So as after when he was released, he marched towards Maharashtra and he tried to talk with Maharani Tarabai for gaddi, but Maharani Tarabai did not accept his claim towards the gaddi. The armies of Shahu Maharaj and Maharani Tarabai fought a battle at Kheda on the bank of the Bhima. So as between Maharani Tarabai and Shahu Maharaj, a battle between both of them had been taken place at place Kheda, which is near the Bhima River. Shahu Maharaj won the battle. So between the Maharani Tarabai and Shahu Maharaj, in that battle, after winning the battle, he captured Satara. Shahu Maharaj captured Satara and he got himself crowned and he sat on Rajgaddi of Maratha territory. So Satara became the capital of the Maratha kingdom. For a while, the mutual opposition between Maharani Tarabai and Shahu Maharaj continued. Maharani Tarabai proclaimed her minor son Shivaji II as the Chhatrapati at Panhala in 1710 CE. This gave rise to an independent Maratha kingdom at Kolhapur besides the one at Satara. So as the kingdom, the Maratha territory had been divided between the two peoples, one side Maharani Tarabai and another side Shahu Maharaj. So as after this opposition, Maharani Tarabai, he decided to proclaim her minor son named Shivaji II as the Chhatrapati of Panhala. So one side Panhala, the Maratha territory, and another side Kolhapur will be under the territory of Shahu Maharaj. So these two peoples were ruling differently at different two places by the side of Maratha territory. The early part of Shahu Maharaj's life was spent in Mughal camps. So he had seen Mughal politics from close quarters. He knew the finer points of Mughals and especially North Indian politics. So as a lot of time Shahu Maharaj had spent in the Mughal camps, due to which he knew each and everything about the Mughal territory, how politically they attack on other people. That all skills was known by the Shahu Maharaj. He knew the strength and weaknesses of the Mughal Empire very well. So as what are the weak points of the Mughals, what are the strength of the Mughals, was well known to Shahu Maharaj, because he had been captured by the Mughal territories, and he was under the Mughal territory people. So he knew the weak points and strength of the Mughal Empire. Also, he was acquainted with the influential people in the Mughal court. All these factors helped him deciding the new direction of Maratha politics in the changing circumstances. So as when he came to Satara district and he crowned himself, he decided to go on a new direction. So by using the different techniques to defeat the Mughal territory. Aurangzeb's successors had given up his policy of destroying the Maratha power. So the Marathas adopted a new policy. Instead of fighting with the Mughal powers, they decided to protect and expand their own empire in that role. So as after the Aurangzeb's death, his successors, without destroying the Maratha power, they had decided to join hands. And also, instead of fighting with the Mughal power, they had decided to protect it and expand their own empire in that role. So according to it, they believe that restoring an old temple is as good as building a new one. So as if we will continue the fight between Marathas and Mughals, so it will be continued. No any profit which they will get. So what? As new building will be good instead of repairing a old temple or old buildings. So they had decided to start a new relation between the Mughal territories and Maratha power. The Mughal power faced the threat of the Irani and Afghani invaders from the northwest, and also of the local Pathan, local Rajput, Jat and Rohilla's rulers. So as these were all the powers to whom they were attacking on the Mughal power. The internal competition and tussle in the court had also weakened the Mughal power. Due to all these, the Delhi court needed the help of the Marathas. So as due to this all circumstances, this due to all the oppositions was against towards the Mughal power. So as Mughals, they need the help of the Maratha power. Balaji Vishwanath. After Shahu Maharaj was released, from Shrivardhan in Kokan, he was competent and experienced. He convinced many sardars that Shahu Maharaj was the real heir of the Maratha Empire and made them join hands with him. So as after when Shahu Maharaj was released from the Mughal territory, he met Balaji Vishwanath and he was a Peshwa. So Balaji hailed from Shrivardhan in Kokan, and he tried to make different sardars by the side of Shahu Maharaj, and he told all the sardars that Shahu Maharaj is the real heel of the Maratha territory. Kanoji Angre was the chief of the Maratha Navy. He chose to side with Maharani Tarabai and attack the territories of Shahu Maharaj. This gave rise to a difficult situation. Under these circumstances, Shahu Maharaj sent Balaji to fight against Kanoji Angre. Balaji avoided the war and won Kanoji over to Shahu Maharaj's side. So as between Kanoji Angre, he was the chief of Maratha Navy, So as he chose to side with Maharani Tarabai and attack the territories of Shahu Maharaj. So under this attack, this gave rise to difficult situation. Under the circumstances, Shahu Maharaj sent Balaji Vishwanath to fight against the Kanauji Angre. So Balaji avoided the war and he won towards the side of Kanauji Angre. So Shahu Maharaj's side, the Kanauji Angre went towards the side of Shahu Maharaj by leaving the side of Maharani Tarabai. Chauthai and Sardesh Mukhi writes, after strengthening the position of Shahu Maharaj in Maharashtra, Balaji turned his attention to the politics in the north. The Delhi court, after the death of Emperor Aurangzeb, was become very influential. With their help, in 1719 CE, Balaji obtained from the Mughal Emperor the grants or sanads to collect Chauthai and Sardesh Mukhi from the Mughal territory in the Deccan. These sanads gave the Marathas the rights to collect 1/4 part, that is Chauthai, and 1/10 part Sardesh Mukhi of the revenue from the Mughal territories in the Deccan. So as under this, the Sardesh Mukhi from the Mughal territory was given to the Maratha territory as a sanad. This sanad gave the Marathas the right to collect the 1/4 part, that is Chauthai and Sardesh Mukhi, from the parts of the Mughal territories, due to which it was beneficial for the Maratha territory. They got profit from this Sardesh Mukhi and Chauthai and Sardesh Mukhi. So as by using this Chauthai and Sardesh Mukhi, they got to collect the taxes from the Mughal territories where the Mughals are having control. From that part, the Marathas will collect the Chauthai and Sardesh Mukhi. This right they got from the Mughal territory. Bajirao first. After the death of Balaji Vishwanath, Shahu Maharaj appointed Balaji's son Bajirao first, the Peshwa, in 1720 CE. So as after the death of Balaji Vishwanath, Shahu Maharaj appointed Balaji's son, his name was Bajirao first, and he was also a Peshwa of 1720 CE, that is Christian era. He expanded the Maratha Empire during his term of 20 years. So as for 20 years, when he was in the term of the 20 years, he tried to extend the power of Maratha territory in all the parts of the country. Shir appointed Nizam-ul-Mulk, the Subedar of Deccan, in 1730 CE. Nizam tried to establish his separate existence at Hyderabad. The emperor had given the Marathas the right to recover Chauthai Sardesh Mukhi from the Mughal areas. Nizam was against it. So as under this circumstances, as the Marathas, they got the right to collect the Chauthai and Sardesh Mukhi from the areas of Mughal. But Nizam, he was against to this decision. He captured some part of the Pune Pargana. Bajirao decided to checkmate the Nizam. So as due to which Bajirao, he decided to defeat the Nizam and to again make control over the Mughal territory parts and to collect the Chauthai and Sardesh Mukhi from that regions. He defeated the Nizam at Palkhed near Aurangabad. So as between Nizam and between Bajirao first, a fight had been taken place, a war had been taken place, and in that battle, Nizam was defeated near Aurangabad. The Nizam accepted the Maratha rights to collect Chauthai and Sardesh Mukhi. And again, the Nizam had accepted the Maratha powers can collect Chauthai and Sardesh Mukhi from the Mughal territory. As the Mughal power had become weak, Bajirao knew that there was more scope to expand the empire towards northern side. Shahu Maharaj supported his policy. So as Bajirao, he knew that now the power of Mughal had been weakened. So it is the time to capture the northern side. So Shahu Maharaj supported Bajirao to collect the parts of the northern side. Malwa in today's Madhya Pradesh was Chimaji Appa to Malwa. There they strengthened this post. So as Malwa, this is the region of Madhya Pradesh, at that place, Bajirao, he sent Mallar Rao Holkar, Ranoji Shinde and Udaji Pawar with the leadership of Chimaji Appa. As Chimaji Appa, he is the brother of Bajirao. He sent all Udaji Pawar, Ranoji Shinde and Mallar Rao Holkar with Chimaji Appa to make a control over the Malwa region and to strengthen their post there. Bundelkhand. Bundelkhand means some part of today's Madhya Pradesh and Uttar Pradesh. Areas around Jhansi, Pana and Sagar. So at Bundelkhand, now a time, it is in the part, some of the part of Madhya Pradesh and some of the part of Uttar Pradesh. That is around Jhansi, Pana and Sagar. So you can find out these two, three places from map. These are the regions where Bundelkhand is situated. King Chhatrasil had established his own kingdom in Bundelkhand. So right, King Chhatrasil was the king of Bundelkhand and he established the own kingdom of Bundelkhand at the Madhya Pradesh and Uttar Pradesh places. The Mughal Subedar Mohammad Khan Bangush of Allahabad attacked Bundelkhand and had defeated Chhatrasil. So I can all this concept in Bajirao Mastani, you can see this concept is related to that picture. As in that picture we can see that the King Chhatrasil need help from the Bajirao, and at that time only as the that Mohammad Khan Bangush, the Subedar of the Mughal, he tried to make attack on the Chhatrasil, and in that situation Bundelkhand had defeated Chhatrasil. Mohammad Khan Bangush had been taken place. At that time, the Chhatrasil was defeated, due to which he asked help to Bajirao to defeat Mohammad Khan Bangush. Bajirao took a large army and went to Bundelkhand. He defeated Bangush, Chhatrasil honored Bajirao. This is how Marathas established their supremacy in Malwa and Bundelkhand. So as all this situation is shown in Bajirao Mastani picture, if you have seen that film, you can come to know the scene. Bajirao demanded from the emperor the office of the Subedar of Malwa. As the emperor declined the demand, Bajirao marched on Delhi in 1737 CE. The Mughals were taken by surprise. Do you know, Chhatrasil wrote a letter to Bajirao. In that he wrote, Jo gat aah Gajendra ki, vah gat aayi hai aaj. Baji jaan Bundel ki, baji rakho laaj. So as what is the meaning of this the sentence, my situation is like the elephant whose leg is caught by the crocodile. You are the only one who can save me. So this type of letter written by Chhatrasil to Bajirao to ask help for them. The Battle of Bhopal. The emperor felt uneasy on account of Bajirao's Delhi expedition. He invited the Nizam to protect Delhi. Nizam marched against Bajirao with the huge army. Bajirao defeated him at Bhopal. Nizam agreed to secure the Sanad of Malwa Subedari for the Marathas and the Badshah. So as this is the Battle of Bhopal, in that the emperor felt uneasy on account of Bajirao's Delhi expedition, due to which he invited at Bhopal. So the name they had given, the Battle of Bhopal. Nizam agreed to after defeating the Nizam, he decided to give the Sanad of Malwa and Subedari for the Marathas from the Badshah. The defeat of the Portuguese. The territories of Vasai and Thane on the Konkan coast were in the possession of the Portuguese. The Portuguese rulers oppressed their subjects. Bajirao sent his brother Chimaji Appa to subdue the Portuguese. Chimaji conquered Thane and adjacent areas in 1739 CE. He laid siege to the Vasai fort. The fort was very strong. The Portuguese had a powerful artillery. In spite of all this, Chimaji continued the siege with perseverance and forced the Portuguese to surrender. The fort of Vasai and large parts of the Portuguese territory passed into the hands of Marathas. So as one situation had been faced with the defeat of Portuguese, how they had defeated the Portuguese. As Bajirao, he sent Chimaji Appa to subdue or to defeat the Portuguese. As at that time, the Chimaji Appa conquered Thane and different adjacent areas in 1739. Also, they had led a siege on Vasai Fort, as the fort was very strong, due to which the Portuguese had a powerful artillery. Then also, Chimaji Appa, by using his artillery and perseverance, he forced the Portuguese to surrender, and the Marathas part or the fort of Vasai and large part of the Portuguese territory was under the control of Maratha territory. So, in the battle between the Portuguese and Chimaji Appa, means Maratha territories, here also the Maratha territories was successful. Death of Bajirao. Nadir Shah, the emperor of Iran, invaded India. Following the order of Shahu Maharaj, Bajirao set out for the north with a big army to defend the Mughal power. By the time he reached Burhanpur, Nadir Shah had returned to Iran with an enormous booty looted from Delhi. In April 1740, Bajirao breathed his last at Rawalpindi on the banks of the Narmada. If you had seen the Bajirao Mastani film, in that also the scene they had shown that when Bajirao, he went to defeat Nadir Shah, the emperor of Iran, as he had invaded India, and by taking the permission from Shahu Maharaj, Bajirao set out for the north for a big army to defend the Mughal powers. And in 1740, while fighting with the Iran, with the Nadir Shah, as Nadir Shah had returned to Iran at that time, in April 1740, Bajirao breathed his last breath at Rawalpindi bank, which is near Narmada. Bajirao was a great general. With his valor, he established the Maratha supremacy in the north. He won status for the Maratha power as a formidable power in the whole of India. In this time, the Shinde, Holkar, Pawar, Gaikwad families attained prominence. So as the about the work of Bajirao, they had given as Bajirao, he was a great general and also he was very courageous and valor. So as Maratha supremacy in the north has been established due to Bajirao, and different peoples, they had also supported Bajirao to fight against the Mughal territories. So in this way, we had completed our chapter, the expansion of the of Maratha power. Now complete the given exercise, read this chapter once again. That's all for today.